again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again.
My name is Louise Sandberg. I'm the archivist at the Lawrence Public Library. I started working with the historical materials in the library in 1998, and this is the first collection that I processed. This collection was sitting in more or less where it is now when I came here in 1996. And when I looked at it, it basically showed individual servicemen from Lawrence and Lawrence only that served in all the services during the Second World War. There was a legend in it at the very front, and when I first processed this collection, I realized that we had these servicemen, someone had done it. I couldn't figure out at the time who it was. I do think I have the answer now. At the bottom of this legend, it has the name Murphy. I went into the city directory in 1943 and found that the assistant librarian for the Lawrence Public Library was an Honora Murphy. And here is her obituary. I believe that she started this process that went from the beginning of the war until a year or so after. And she died shortly after she started it, I think. But I believe she's the one who started putting it in order. There are various different writing at the top of them that means more than one person. That it would have been library staff, I believe, who were compiling these newspaper clippings on these cards. There are many cards that do have nothing on them. They will have a name. There are a few that are missing. They were sitting here for decades, probably in the old building too, for decades before I started working with them. I took them out of the old boxes they were in and put them in acid-free boxes, as you see here. Once I had written them up, what I knew about them at the time, I sent along the finding aid, which is what we call the document, a Word document, to explain what a collection is. I sent that to the Library of Congress. It was put into what librarians call a MARC record. On the Library of Congress catalog, and now is presently in the Merrimack Valley Library Consortium website. Later on, I started my own blog, or catablog as I like to call it, and have put in a record or a post for this collection. With the help of Joyce Bodenrader and others, we have indexed the entire collection, and the index is on the post on the blog. The blog is called queencityma.wordpress.com. Just recently, the city councilman from South Lawrence, Mark LaPlante, approached me about information about individuals from Lawrence who were buried in cemeteries in Normandy, in France. I was able to find the ones he asked for. I sent him a file with these cards on it by email. He has been posting these on his Facebook page now for 2 or 3 weeks. Once he started doing this, and I started receiving them, I thought, well, other people might be more interested in these files as well. So we posted on Facebook my blog post, and I have now received about 45 requests for information. I do this entirely free of charge. We scan the cards, we send them out via email, or people can come in and do it themselves. I am here to help you, I am very happy that we've made so many contacts with people virtually everywhere, all over the world, who want information about their family members. please come. Go in to queencityma.wordpress.com. Put in a search for World War II veterans. Go on to the post. You'll see the links to various parts of the alphabet. You'll find them in there. There's more than 8,000 of these individual cards, yes. Again, some of the cards have nothing on them except the name. Sometimes there's more than one card, and there's a front and back. There's a lot of stuff on some of them. Information includes marriages, children, unfortunately, the death on occasion, engagements, home on leave, all that sort of thing. Someone back, or the staff of the library, must have cared very deeply about this kind of thing. And I'm glad I was able to provide it for people.
We'll meet again. Don't know when. Don't know when. But I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away.